What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Difernt. Welcome to Difference Well. Today's vlog, I'm going to be sharing with you all my audio interview with Letsb Real Podcast. I had a very good time talking with the host, Shay, about my new book, What If? A Controversial Paradigm Shift, which is on pre-sale now on my website, differenceworld.net. So I don't want to waste any more of you guys' time. I want to hop right into it. Here it is. Check out the podcast interview. I hope you guys enjoy.
What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Shay, on this Wednesday, and my special guest in the building today is my girl, Difernt, with us. What's going on?
Hey, Queen. How are you? Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, it's
glad to be here. Appreciate to be here.
Yes, I know we have been trying to get this date set and locked in so that we can get the show going, but let me just tell you a little bit about me, Difernt. Oh, my God. This past week has been so busy for me. Yesterday was my birthday.
And happy belated.
Oh, thank you. You know, Virgos are, we are something special. So,
but y'all, I thank y'all all that, but okay. Let you have your mom. It's your time. Let me have your time. Do your thing.
But I'm going to celebrate this weekend because I've been working. You know, I work too as well. So I'm working 10-hour shifts. So then I try to rush home and I try to make sure the content is still here for the show. I've been doing so much new things with the show. So it's definitely going to be worth it, worth the while for the last week that I did miss. But birthday celebration is going to be this weekend. But let's get into you, my girl. We have so much to offer when we're talking about Difernt. Difernt, let the people know what's going on with you.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. So, like Shay told everybody, my name is Difernt, spelled D-I-F-E-R-N-T, and I'm 30 years old in Houston, Texas. Let's see. My hobbies, I love traveling, meditating, writing, journaling, exercising, anything pretty much there, but I'm like, I'm in for it. So, that's me in a nutshell. I guess as far as my background, I'll let you ask the questions and what you want to know about me. So
no, you fine. So I do hear that your hobbies and everything is like meditating. So when it does come down to it, I do see that you have a what if book. So in this what if book, like, how do you go from meditating to actually putting out a book? You're publishing a book.
Well,
what does that fit
not
in?
Not just with meditating, but as far as being spiritually in tune and what that is for me, is meditating, praying, and being alone with God. Okay. I'm not necessarily such as a religious person, and again, I'm no attack or anybody that is, no disrespect, but for me, I had to lose religion in order to gain a relationship with God. And so, ever since then, you know, for me, what I do is I pray, meditate, read the Bible. I even do, you know, chakra healing and, you know, things of that nature, making sure my energies are clean and keeping my aura positive. And so as far as like when praying and manifesting things that I want into life, this book is sort of play and speak with it.
So we're going to get it a little bit into this book. And so as I share this book with our viewers and listeners, just give me the background about the title of the book and what is the vision for the book.
Okay, yeah, so the book, my new book, my first book, What If? A Controversial Paradigm Shift. Before I go any further, I'm going to state that this book does include a disclaimer. It's intended for mature audience only. And so if you can't take this type of heat, don't come to this kitchen. The book was written to inform and encourage thought-provoking and constant conversations about systemic racism and injustice in America. This is done through provocative, but graphically provocative illustrations. And it details on controversial deaths and events that have occurred in America within the African American community over time and basically what's still going on in time. The way that I have constructed the book is in four main categorized paradigms, which are historical, political, precedent, and hypothetical. And within those four main paradigms, there are sub-paradigms that are basically just asking the question, you know, what if the shoe was on the other foot? Yeah. What if this happened to white people instead of black people? And so the way that, like I said, I have it set up with the even with the questions that they don't get you, the illustrations are definitely meant to do so. So for instance, one of the paradigms that I've had in historical I believe I have the question I asked towards the year 1619, I believe, and asked the question, what if in 1619, Africans started doing slave trading, whereas they kidnapped millions of English men, women, and children from their homeland and brought them on slave ships to America? And so, and then you'll see this illustration of, you know, white slaves in shackles and on the slave ship, and you have the black slave masters, you know, with how they used to do us. And so, although the book, it is set up with, you know, graphic illustrations that will definitely ruffle some feathers and ring some bells, the overall gist of the book, if you can sum it through the entire book and make it to the last paradigm, which is hypothetical, that is where I tie it all into my message of, you know, thinking about just compassion and bringing unity and having love for men and everybody in general. You're a little jumbled up, my words here, but that's okay. Once you read the book, you'll understand where I'm coming from.
it's okay, because like you said, the what if, like, mm-hmm. what would time or today or history be like if it was on, if the shoe was on the other foot? That what if question is going to always be an unanswered question, because it's a what if question. It's not like it really has been in effect. And once again, I can't say what discrimination any other nationality might have experienced, but when it does come down to us African Americans, it's like racism is just never going to end for us, because even if we're not experiencing amongst, you know, everyday people out there, we still have racism when it comes down to discrimination of jobs, housing, police brutality. So exactly. Racism, I believe racism come down to the food, you know, and I can just be, don't quote me hypothetically, but there's white milk, there's chocolate milk. Everything has to do with a color, and it's just weird. And it's like, how do we go from this? So when you wrote this book, the what if, who was your targeted audience for this book?
So, as I was chatting with you before, I'm a businesswoman, and before I was an author, that's what I used to do, and that's what I still do. And I'm a strong believer in, you know, if anything that it is that you want to do, you have to, you know, take yourself serious, and if you want people to take you serious. And so, therefore, do your research, do your homework, and just gather all the information you can before you, you know, dive into it all the way. And so for me, what I did was, before I wrote the book, or while I was writing the book, if you will, I did a test market analysis, and I was able to find my four main target components that make my audience, and which is, you know, adults that are from the ages of 18 to 35, people that's a part of the African American community. It did test high with both women and men, but of course, women we the world, so we're gonna run it up with the numbers.
Okay.
As well as those who care about social issues like injustice and, you know, police reform, or, you know, talking about, you know, systemic change. And so if you ask that question, who's my target audience, it's four main target components, if you will, and those are those four. However, the book is intended for everybody. I want everybody all over to read the book, because it doesn't just apply to racism, if you will, or just black and white. You can apply these paradigms in different other shifts, if you will, you know. And so, but with the gist of the reason why, if you ask the question why I chose and hone in on, you know, racism and why I chose this topic, if you will, it's because of a number of things, but it's four main ones. Is one, what happened with George Floyd, you know, me being from Houston, Texas. I grew up in Fifth Ward, but I also spent some time in Third Ward. And so when he passed away, I wanted to get involved and have my voice being heard. However, you know, it was just, when it came down to it, I couldn't. Not because I got cold feet, but because I wanted my voice to be heard longer than just in that moment of time. I wanted to be heard long after I'm gone. And so, like I said, being a person that is spiritually in tune and, you know, like to talk with God and just actually fear to the sermon, excuse me. Just talking and having him show me little bitty pieces of, you know, visions here and there and dreams, and talking with people, and just it coming together, as well as another issue that I had, you know, in my life with mental health. Coming up, I guess, going back to giving you guys a little bit of my background, I had a good childhood up until the time I was 11 years old, and then, you know, me and my family basically ended up homeless on the street for 3 years. And by the time I was 14, I was secretly placed in foster care by relatives. And for the first 6 months, my family didn't know where I was. However, during that time, I found out that if you stayed in foster care and aged out, the state of Texas would pay for your tuition fee waiver. And so by the time that my family found me and I was ready to go home, I made the decision to stay. And okay. So that my college can be paid for it. So, you know, I used my street smarts to elevate my book smarts.
Okay.
And just went ahead and do that those 4 years and ended up, you know, going to San Jose State University and getting my degrees in international business. I also have two minors in economics and business communication. I also have a master's degree in entrepreneurship, as well as I'm a Texas real estate agent. Not to mention, like I said, I'm an avid traveler, so I like to travel all over the world and just do amazing things. And although my story started in tragedy, it is in triumph. All this
okay.
He brought me through it all, and he still is. And you would think with all those accomplishments I had under my belt, Shay, I had it together, but I didn't. Yeah. A lot of my childhood trauma, you know, stemmed over into my adulthood to where yeah. the point to I got it was for me, it was not chaos was normal. And so when I got taken out of that situation and placed into foster care, I was placed in nice homes and in good school districts. However, again, like I said, it was, you know, it wasn't normal to me. So I felt it was too good to be true.
Okay.
And I would sabotage it and get kicked out of, you know, all of the foster homes that I was in. But sometimes I aged out of care. That's pretty much how, you know, foster care went for me.
Yeah.
And those type of traits, it spilled over into my adulthood to the point to where all of the good opportunities I had to, you know, advance my career, I was squandering them because I, you know, was doing what I felt was normal, what I was used to, and mm-hmm. to the point to where I kept messing up so much to where I had to face the ugly truth about myself that
yeah.
it was on me. I needed to go fix my issues. Although
yeah.
what I went through in the past, it wasn't my fault. It was out of my control. Somehow, some way, it's my problem, and I got to
yeah.
fix it.
Absolutely.
And so that's just what I did. I dismissed that notion that, you know, black people don't do therapy, and I took my ass to therapy. You know, coming up in that environment where, you know, you taught, you know, what goes on in this house stays in this house. So, you know,
right.
you don't talk about, you know, what happened with Uncle Tootsie. You don't talk about it. I'm not saying it happened to me, but, you know, in
oh,
some families, you know, you tell and they still just blow it off.
Yeah.
And so that's the type of environment, you know, I grew up in. And so coming up in my adulthood and having those issues and being in denial about, you know, needing to fix them, eventually it pushed me to the point to where I was going to self-destruct, and me knowing in my heart of hearts, I'm meant for greatness. God put me here for a reason. So many times he could have taken me out, but he hasn't. He kept me right here. So I'm here for a purpose, and I can't squander. It'll be on me if I didn't use all my gifts and talents before my time is up, before I leave this earth. And so I broke down on my knees and prayed to God and told him, you know, I need to get it together. And like I said, went to therapy. And for the past 2 years, I've been serious about it and been consistent with it, and I'm proud of it. And because look what came out of it, being in therapy and talking to my therapist, you know, he encouraged me to turn a negative into a positive and go back to what I love, which was writing and journaling. So being stuck in the house and then during the pandemic and just doodling and writing words of affirmation, then the death of George Floyd happened.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, like I said, I want to get involved. I don't know, but however, I want my voice to be heard longer than in a moment of time. And like I said before, just praying and meditating, and then bit by bit, piece by piece, I just started writing, you know, what if that? And so that started June 2020. And by December 2020, I had finished writing the writing part of the book. Now I needed to find, you know, illustrated still and everything. But I get in contact with my lawyer, and I let her know I have something I think is going to be really good, and I show it to her. She responds, she's like, yeah, I think you're going to do really good. This is,
okay.
And, but one thing, you know, what's the name of your business? And so, you know, just what I for Shay, think you know something, and then life comes through and swoop.
Yeah.
Mind you don't know shit.
You so, know what? It's weird that you said that, though, because it's not even just with your situation. I think that just with, period, everyday life situations. You can use that metaphor to relate it to a lot of other topics as well.
Mm-hmm. And so when I did that and got real with myself, and this is what came out of it, the what if. And so, like I said, when I was talking with the lawyer, she asked, what's the name of your business? And mind you, I was just wanted to write a book to have my voice heard. I had no intention of starting a book, excuse my business right now because of the pandemic. Okay. However, you know, that's just the way God works. When he says it's time, he'll set everything in motion for me, and that's just how it's been going for me. And so December 2020, she tells me, hey, you need to have a business in order to sell product to the public. That's usually how it goes. So from that time to March 2021, you know, I'm learning, you know, my gains of the business and small business operations in Texas. And by the time March 2021 rolls around, TH3RD EYE Entertainment LLC was formed, which is my business. And our creed, if you will, is that we strive to bring social awareness to society through our products and services that educate, inspires, and entertains all at once. We also have a motto. It's called Manifest, Plan, Prepare. And in order for this is what we believe, which is TH3RD EYE Entertainment believes, in order for those who believe in their heart of heart that they are meant for guaranteed success, the first thing they must do is manifest and speak into existence the which they believe and feel and desire in their heart that they are meant to have, and never stop believing it.
Absolutely.
So I'm writing it out on paper and just manifesting it to no end.
Yeah.
And whatever it is that you want in life, you know, you want to get your own business, you want to, you know, go out for that audition, whatever it is, you know, manifest.
Write it down, manifest.
Remove that fear and replace it with faith. Get rid of all that negative doubt and reprogram your mind and let nothing and no one tell you nothing different from what it is that you want and believe that you're supposed to have. And you manifest and speak it like no other. Already act as if it's yours, that it's in your life, like it's in your hand already. Second, you must plan for what it is that you want to do in life and what you want to have in life. So whether if you want to, you know, have that luxury car or house, you have to plan that out. Whatever it is, you write it out on paper. You start putting that plan to action. Start fixing your finances. Start fixing, you know, if you, you know, want to get yourself, you know, in health and shape, hit that gym up.
Yeah.
Whatever it is that you need to fix, your mental health, go fix it. You know, go mend that broken relationship with your family. Fix all those issues that you that can come back to haunt you whenever you're reaping your, you know, fruits of your labor. Fix that now so you won't have to worry about it later on.
Yeah.
So once you plan that out, move on to the preparation part of it. Prepare for what it is that you are about to receive. So, like I said, prepare as far as getting yourself together from the inside out, fixing your mental, your spiritual, your financial, your physical, you know, going to mend those broken bridges, fixing your credit, whatever it is, prepare for what it is that you want to receive. You have to be prepared. My grandmother told me long ago, you know, if you want you to have a good man in your life and you want to be a good woman, like, make sure you have yourself together before you, you know, get, you know, involved with that man. Get your credit right. You know, get your weight right, whatever it is that you like. Like I said, I got mommy and daddy issues, so I got to go fix that before I go get with my dude and have issues, you know, that I'm bringing from my past into the future relationship. So I need to fix that before I get into a serious relationship. That's the type of preparation that I mean when I say manifest, plan, and prepare.
I mean, it's good to define it. Find it, but at the same time, you know, a lot of people take heed to things a different way and goes different routes. So whatever works best for you, but as you heard, let's be real, my girl Difernt just told us that we have to learn to manifest things, like prepare things, you know, speak things into existence into your life. You know, also when it does come down to, you know, spiritual, my pastor, he just had a ceremony I'm going to say 2 Sundays ago, and he was talking about cultivating. Sometimes you have to cultivate things, and a lot of people don't understand what that terminology means, or just like when you said it comes down to the controversial paradigm. Do you know paradigm really means for something major to really happen in this world? So whether if it's in a relationship, your everyday life, you writing a book, you driving a car, or whatever it is, if you're doing something in your life that's going to be positive or going to have some type of payoff for you later in your life, it's a major change. Even if you're saying no, it could be a major effect onto your life. So you do have to manifest some things, speak it into existence. It's good to always mend relationships. But what about when you come and you have all this education, you have all this to offer someone into this book, but it still just doesn't get through to them? What is your expectations for someone who does read the book? What is the outcome you're looking for them to have?
Well, my expectation is not to have an expectation of a certain, it's just like I said, whether the people are good or bad, the bell has been rung. Okay. And so I'm not here to change the world, change my, it's just to make you think, you know, ask the question, what if? Another reason what sparked me to write the book is because I'm tired of, you know, racist people of the world stating that racism doesn't exist, isn't alive, or if it's alive, it's because we, the people, are keeping it alive. And so another question I asked, okay, well, how about this? How about we do a little race role reversal? How about we hold the mirror up to you and show you what we see and how we feel, what we've been going through?
Yeah.
And if it's not okay for you to see an illustration of a white person being lynched or dragged or whatever, but yet you turn around and you see a black person lynched, but always justified. Oh, it happened. Let's get over it. You know, you have every excuse except for saying that it's wrong.
Yeah.
And that's how you know that racism is still alive. So I'm not only just doing this to ring bells or ruffle feathers. Like I said, it's also meant to start the conversation. Whether people are talking about it good or bad, they're going to talk about it. And for me, that's one of the ways I feel that we can create change, is to acknowledge and address and talk about those issues, deep-seated root issues that, you know, nobody likes to talk about. And although, and I'm well aware that, you know, change doesn't happen overnight, and it doesn't happen with just one person. But what if, Shay, what if this is the generation that plants the seed for the next, for the next? So that's my hope and prayer. I'm not trying to, you know, ruffle any feathers. It's just like I said, I wanted to do something, have my voice being heard long after I'm gone, and make people think and educate them and inspire them and entertain them. A lot of my readers who read them, a lot of them didn't know these issues happened that I have in the book. They didn't know. They were very, like, once, for instance, a person of color, he didn't know that George Washington, he used his slave's teeth for his own. He didn't know that.
Okay.
And so my book not only is to make people upset or make them uncomfortable, but it educates as well.
Absolutely. It says come and learn. It says it.
Yeah.
Come and learn.
And so, yeah, come and learn. And so it's not just, again, I don't want to be repetitive, but I can't stress it enough, because a lot of, I'm sure when people get it, they will say, you know, this can be a tool that the black community is using to uprise against the white community. No, it's not. Mm-mm. Stop that right here and now.
Mm-mm.
This is strictly meant to make you think, you know, about the things and actions that have gone on in our country to our people, black people.
Oh,
I'm simply asking the question. What if this was happening to you and your ancestors?
Yep.
What if this is still happening? Would still be happening?
Yep.
You know, is it okay? Is it justified?
I believe the way someone responds,
what now?
The way they respond to it is, it will let you know what do they feel about racism, because many people.
Oh yeah.
Many people will say you can't see it, but you can experience it.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, that's the terminology when it does come down to race with others. But like I said, if you just thinking that racism goes with color, that does not just define it. You can be discriminated on housing, the way you work. So discrimination and the racism controversial with the paradigm.
I got you, good paradigm.
You know what?
Paradigm.
I have.
But yeah. Also, Shay, I also
butchering things.
Go ahead.
I'm bad with butchering things.
Oh no, it's okay. Me too.
But yeah, with the paradigm though, like I said, once again, it is something like, it's a major change, you know, and a lot of people don't know that, like even when the internet came to the world, you know, so that was a major change though for the world, because now you get to trade out most of the marketings, and when it comes down to like business, they was trading each other off because now the internet get to do more for them. But it's a major change, like COVID still is a major change. So some people might don't know what the word paradigm mean. Paradigm means a major change, and that's why she used that word paradigm with controversial, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yes, okay. Ma'am. Let me know right off the bat. Controversial paradigm shift.
Absolutely.
Make no mistake about it.
We definitely is going to share a video a little bit more that comes from the different website. So I do definitely like this website. So what can you purchase this book from? I do see it say new book, What If? Controversial mm-hmm. Paradigm Shift is coming. That was August 20, 2021. So what can we publish this book at? Purchase it.
Yeah, so for now, I'm doing a pre-sale.
Okay.
I'm actually working with Amazon right now. I have my transcript uploaded. And then once that's the green check, I can start the pre-sale. That's honestly where I'm at with it.
So when it comes down to What If, do you see you coming out with a second part?
So it's like this for me. I'm more, like I said, more just one option. I don't just talk about racism with my business with Third Eye NFT. We talk about issues that are taboo. So we not just with injustice, systemic racism. We talk about women's rights, voters' rights, sex trafficking, you know, domestic relationships, LGBTQ issues.
Yeah.
All the issues that are swept under the rug, we bring it to light at Difference World. I do also on the intimate side, like the training, the traveling, and the food experts, and so I do a blogging and blog as well. But as far as other projects that we have going, What If is just the first product. We also sell other products and associated with the book that's available on the website.
Okay.
It will be available later on September. It won't be available on Amazon or Barnes & Noble, but just to the website only.
Okay.
I'm also looking to do a book tour. This depends on how COVID is going. I hope it lets up. I pray it does. next semester. I can't say semester when I'm in college. next spring, if you will, I'm looking to do prospective 35 universities and then 15 states.
Okay.
Starting with Howard and working my way on down.
I want to definitely share this video clip of it. It's very interesting.
Yeah.
So
I'm warning you guys, we're mature audience always.
Let's get into this. Viewer's discretion is advised. Oh my gosh, Third Eye.
What if in 1619 Africans started dealing through slave trading?
The tables were turned around.
What if they took down millions of Englishmen, women, and children from their homeland and brought them to America on a slave ship?
What if a controversial paradigm shift is a book written to inform and encourage consistent, thought-provoking conversations about injustice and systematic racism in America through graphic but provocative illustration? What If provides a different perspective by detailing controversial deaths and events as four categorized paradigm shifts: historical, political, precedent, and hypothetical. What If, a controversial paradigm shift by author Difernt. Illustration.
I love it. Even in a short video, you give out so much information, like with the what ifs and the questions. I love how everything look when it comes down to the illustration. Everything fit, mm-hmm. It blends in. It is so good. So when you
shout out to my illustrator.
Yes. How long did it actually take you to put this thought together? Because I know you said you started like in June, and then by December you was putting it out here when it came down to the illustration. So
I found my illustrator March 2021 this year, and she just finished a little July like.
Okay.
So she was pretty quick with it, and like I said, God, he sent the right people at the right time. And she was one of them. So shout out to my illustrator, Anastasia Arnold.
So where's your goals for the book? Like, are you looking to land it into a store? Are you just
this is gonna be a number one bestseller. This is the book that rings the bell around the world.
Okay.
I manifested, planning and preparing. I practice what I teach over here in this world. So we going to be a number one bestseller, Nobel Peace Prize, a Pulitzer Prize. We went in awards. We turned this book into a script.
What about a movie?
From my mouth to God's ears. Well, I don't think it'll be a movie. What I'm looking for it to be is like a mini TV series part, like a four-part mini TV series. I could see like Tyler Perry or Regina King taking it over. I would definitely want them to do some work with it.
All right, those was my questions. Like, if you could work with someone or anybody up there on a little bit more professional level, who would you want to work with? Everybody always talking about Tyler Perry.
He didn't put on for the community, if you will.
He definitely put on for us. You know what? I had a movie producer, a movie film writer that was on my show. And he was just sharing his experience going to the Tyler Perry Studios, trying to, promote his business to them. Like, he wanted to try to collab, or he just wanted Tyler Perry to look at. They wouldn't even let him in through the studios. And I was like, oh my gosh, Tyler Perry, I know you ain't going to get up there and do us like this now.
Yeah, it'd be like this in time.
You know what?
When you make it big.
You have to. You do want to have security around. You do want to make sure who you are letting around you, because some people right now will sell you a story just to get up there to cut your throat. So I am aware of that. I am.
Yeah.
I'm very
aware. But it's also, again, don't forget where you come from. So I understand what you're talking about. but if we're really being real, then I want a black queen to work. So it's going to be either Regina King or Ava DuVernay.
Okay. Now, I love Regina King. I love her.
Yeah, that's my girl. Yeah, I love her.
She good with it. She's good. Regina King is definitely good. I don't know why I always thought her name was Regina Hall. Because Regina...
Because they look like sisters.
Okay, so it is a Regina Hall, right?
Yeah, it's two of them. Regina Hall and Regina King. Regina King's been brought way longer than Regina Hall.
Okay, so who is Regina Hall?
Think like a man...
Regina Hall. So who is
that? That's a scary movie.
Okay.
So and Regina King, Thin Line Between Love and Hate. Have you seen that movie?
Oh yeah.
Let me get another one. This Christmas with Chris Brown.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, oh, okay, yeah, that is her. Okay, but I'm like, I know it was a Regina Hall. So you know I'm bad with movies. I just watch them. I watch them just to get a feeling, emotion. I want to cry. I want to know something. I'm not a movie critic, so I do not keep up with all the actor's name or actress name. No,
yeah.
I don't. But so when it does come down, are you looking to do like a book signing? What's coming up?
Oh, definitely. We're having the book launch.
Okay.
I try to be upfront and tell people what's going on. So when people hear and they go to my website, this is not what you said, different. What you see is what you get.
Well, I'm in Houston.
I'm going by myself.
I'm in Houston, Texas, even though I'm from Chicago. So I would definitely come and support.
Oh, okay. Well, for sure. Well, it's not the fact that I don't have it, but it's going, we in Houston and they have the COVID going up again. So I did have a venue, but if what was told to me is that things going lockdown, then it's not going to happen. And so I don't want to say something and then it doesn't go the way it plans. And so I just try to tell people out there listening, just check out my website and I'll keep you guys updated.
Well, you know, have you thought about, because I have seen a lot of movie producers now, like some of the movie theaters are not open and allowing you to actually come in and sit there and watch the movie. Maybe you could do a book launch or a book release by doing like a Zoom or something online or something. That maybe
I but I want that physical like interaction, face to face, and like.
Listen, I have a podcast I started when I got here, and I just been doing it in the home. But I don't. I'm not gonna speak and let my right hand know my left hand is doing. But I'm soon to have me a studio, so I know what you mean. It's like
speaking into existence, manifest. I know you don't. I get what you're saying with that, but you gotta remove that negative thought and replace it with fear and start manifesting it. Get it down on paper. Get you a little boy like how I did. And you start writing, I will write my book. I will have a number one bestseller.
Absolutely.
You get that in your mind. Once you just manifest and remove all that negative doubt, get a spiritually attuned with your third eye. Absolutely. Nothing stopping you, sis. Nothing.
So what is Third Eye Entertainment LLC?
Yeah, so again, with my lawyer telling me, hey, I needed a business, praying, manifesting, and talking with God and being spiritually attuned. This is what I came up with, Third Eye Entertainment. And the reason why I have it called Third Eye is because when you allow yourself to be in tune with your spiritual side, aka your third eye, your sixth sense, whatever you want to call it, you, for me, when I was able to give room myself and admitted the ugly truth that I needed to go get therapy and fix my issues, I was able to, you know, get my heart right and then get my mind right.
Yeah.
So once you do that, you unlock the, you know, ultimate chakra. Your third eye has been locked. You're able to see things so clear now. Things that you didn't want to accept, like, you know, those relationships that's no good for you. You see them and you're okay with letting it go.
Yeah.
And so that's what Third Eye is about. And also, like I said, we talk about issues that are bring social awareness to society and that pushes and motivates for social change. And so that's what my business is about. That's what I'm about, you know, being that person that's not afraid to be who I am and speak on issues that need to be spoken on, even if that costs me. I'm not trying to be nobody's martyr or start nobody's ride or
somebody
that person, but I do have something to say. And like I said, I believe that I was meant for greatness and that God selected me for a special assignment. And this is it. Not to mention, long ago, I prayed and asked God to allow me to be the one in my family to break that generational curse and create generational wealth. And so this is one of the ways, you know.
Okay.
So by any means necessary, I'm going to get it. And with Third Eye, like I said, our motto is manifest, plan, prepare. But also, what it stems deeper as with the pandemic. This year alone, I've already lost 4 people and just had my attended a funeral of a mentor 2 weeks ago. And just want to say rest in peace to Coach Saul Solis, my mentor at the Metro Fight Club in Houston, Texas. But in the midst of the pandemic, it showed us all and reminded us all that life is not promised. That life is short and tomorrow is not promised. And so for anybody that's feel in their heart that they're meant for greatness and that they're supposed to have a better life than what they're living right now. Now is the time.
Yeah.
You know, get the heart, your mind, you rest together, get your shit together and go after what's yours.
Yeah.
You know, I always tell my friends, it's you either trying to have that come up like Cardi B or that come back like Robert D. There is no in between. So, you know, it's time to get rich during the pandemic or die trying. That's that mode I'm in. And I'm not messing with anybody who don't have that type of mindset.
Man.
And so, if you a village, a tribe, a crew, or whoever, whatever you want to call it, that think like you and feel how you feel, and that's how you reach that next level that you're trying to get to. That's how I was able to do it. That's how I'm doing it. And it's not hard. It's not easy. It's definitely going to be hard. Definitely gonna have setbacks. I've had so many setbacks with this book and with this project, but that only just showed me that, you know, when all the badness comes against you, when you have something good going on, that's when you keep pushing forward.
Absolutely.
That's how you know you're meant for greatness. It's when something's trying to stop you, that negative or comes opposed and try to, you know, stop what you got good going for you,
yeah,
that's when you're supposed to go harder. It's when you're supposed to keep going faster, faster, and don't stop.
And don't worry about trying to prove no points. Like, explain why nothing. Keep going.
Yep. And so it also, it even what I also try to, you know, stimulate with people or relate to people, if you will, even with this book, people gonna be talking about it bad, sure enough. But whether they're talking about it good or bad, the bell has been rung. And what I have learned from our previous one, number 45, I don't acknowledge him as mine because he's not. But number 45, what I've learned from him is that no matter what you do, no, what you believe in, how you feel, people always condone your BS. This man was in office for 4 years, and even afterwards, towards the end, all that ruckus he caused, he still had 25% of the U.S. adult population still condoned his BS. That's 75 million people, Shay. Mm-hmm. So no matter what it is that you believe in, what you stand for, it's always going to be somebody out there mm-hmm. that's going to condone it. Of course, there's going to be somebody out there that's going to be against it. But just go towards the people that's always for you no matter what. You go where you celebrate it, not where you tolerate it. So if there's anybody out there that's listening and thinking, oh, well, she's not going to do good with these books still. Oh, well, they ain't no mic because she don't close a lot of uploads. I'm not worried about that.
We sure
are. I know what my target audience is. I know where they at. So I'm going to go where I'm celebrating, not where they target. I'm
just not gonna, even not just that. I know why God brought me to the front. You know, it say when mm-hmm. God bring you to the front, that's all that matter. I don't care who promote me, who share it, or who with me. You don't got to do none of that. But in a minute, they're going to be paying me for interviews. Watch, okay?
Exactly. So just keep going. Give yourself 2 years of consistency and put in work.
Absolutely.
And just... I would have never imagined this 2 years ago, a year ago, had I not just kept writing and keep going. And, of course, there would be days that I catch writer's block and want to, you know, be lazy about it, but I got back at it.
Yeah.
And just kept writing. And so if you just put the bare minimal efforts in, you will receive the bare minimum results. But think of it as if you put the maximum effort, then you're going to receive the maximum results.
Yeah, absolutely. Some people just got to learn how to dismantle a lot of the stagnation that has them in life. You got to let go a lot of things. You do not need to mm-hmm. be afraid. But like you said, that'll be on another one-on-one coaching because mm-hmm. you are neither not perfect. But I do see that at the end of the day, when I'm woke, you woke. We working, baby. We don't got time to sleep. Sometimes you have to miss fun to stack some funds. That's what I'm talking about. I'm all up to something else. I'm on to better things. I'm on to better things. I know you're I'm on the one thing that's going to make me elevate. No, but I definitely like that song. So. But it has definitely been a pleasure to have you to come on to the show today on Let's Be Real and just educate everyone on the controversial paradigm of racism that is going on out here. I do love the website. So
yes, please.
For people who are interested in reading the book, where can they go just to read it at, to download it, stream it? Where can they go?
So I'm having a pre-sale starting next week.
Okay.
To keep updated with me, just again, check out my website, differenceworld.net. So DIFERNTSWORL.net. differenceworld.net. I guess that's where you can find all our social media handles, but our main social media they're on right now is Facebook. You can find me at Third Eye LLC. Hi, I got a phone tagline. Sorry. TH3RD LLC EYE. But you can go to differenceworld.net and see that.
So before I let you go, I have a question. Are you interested in doing like pop up shops?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Have you done one before?
I have not, but I'm looking to do so in October, November. Right now, it's the pre-sale, then the book launch, and then also maybe we can talk about the pop-up shop, and then I'm looking to do a book tour.
I definitely am going to talk to you because I am hosting one. And so without Houston, I have not so much networking. I have met a lot of entrepreneurs, a lot of different type of chefs, cooks, upholsteries, all type of different things. So I'm like, okay, you know what? I'm just going to do a pop-up shop. At first, it was going to be because I didn't know so many Chicago people has moved. Like, I was like, wow, a lot of people move. We all done brought our badasses from up there to come down here. But no. But no.
My cousin was one of y'all. Lily, let me ask you this, Shay. I can't believe this.
What?
Fish and spaghetti?
Yes, and I'm tired of y'all down here with this food. Fish and spaghetti goes together.
No, it does not.
Let me tell you my experience.
Listen here, we don't talk to our cousin's boyfriend because of this.
Listen, I work for American Healthcare Medical Association. So long story short, they had brought me some kolaches. I don't know what kolaches is, but when they brought it to me, it was like a pig in a blanket. I'm like, I don't want no hot dog.
A big one.
No bun on it. And they was cracking up. They was like, Shay, what do you mean this is a pig in a blanket? I'm like, this is a pig in a blanket. Y'all don't know a lot of stuff. So don't do us Chicago people. It is so hot down here, but I do love Houston. I just love the atmosphere. I do like the networking that I'm doing. The opportunities are amazing here. The housing is so much better.
I'm on the interview. Sorry.
So it's amazing. So I can bring some of my north a little bit to the south, and we could try to meet up in the Midwest or something. Let's just create our own little different type of town and state now. But it is a lot of people from Chicago that has came down here to Houston. And so everybody, like, it's a Chicago food truck here. I met so many people from Chicago doing a lot of different stuff. They opened up a Harold's Chicken. So at first, the pop-up shop was going to be for everyone that has really moved their stuff from Chicago, because violence is everywhere. You know, don't get me wrong. Violence is all across the 50 states. Like you said, George Floyd was from here, Houston, Texas, but he went somewhere else. And unfortunately, that, you know, it ended his life. But it's violence is everywhere. And it does just play a part amongst us living out here amongst each other. We have police, accidental deaths, all type of things. But I'm going to say, when I did start my podcast, of course, I'm from Chicago. So it's so much violence. I wanted to just promote a lot of the positivity that still lies out there amongst the negativity with the violence, the killing, and all that. My city, my state, we do have great people in Chicago. So I was going to do a pop-up shop in Houston for all Chicago people, but then I saw how the Houston people was looking at me like different. So I'm like, I'm going to just add y'all in the shop now. But it's not just...
But you know what it is with us? It's something here for everybody. This is like, one thing I love about Houston, even though we in the South, this is like the open-minded
Yes.
South, if you will. Houston, we have something for everybody, you know.
Yes.
Straight, gay, black, white, doesn't matter. You know, out of state people from Chicago. Yeah, I can come down here and get y'all some and make y'all own. But that's what I love about, you know, my city. You know, yes. We open-minded, we, you know, open-hearted. And yes. I guess that's just a part of who I am as well. But make no mistake.
Okay.
Make no mistake about it. I'm nobody, you know, puppet, a plaything.
Okay.
That's one thing about the South. We got that Southern hospitality for you, but we also got some bangers, too.
Look, I'm a killer, but don't push me.
Push me? Well, you ain't got to push me. I'm already there.
Did you see that, though, on the news? They did say that they are making it to where people as old as 18 could carry guns now. I'm like, oh, my gosh.
Well, yeah, that's no thing. And this is Texas. People younger carrying guns, it's like nothing out here.
But
and I don't mean to sound so nonchalant about it, but when you say guns in Texas, that's just like saying I need a glass of water.
But see, I watched it on the news and I heard it and I was like, oh my gosh, I never seen out of 32 years of my life living it that they told you, oh, it's okay, you can carry a gun. Like, do you know how many more people are going to die around here? You know how many trigger happy people? Just don't make that rule in Chicago. Don't make that rule in Illinois. They are already buying guns. They don't need.
And that's kind of crazy because I like Chicago because, don't get it twisted, I don't condone violence, but I've always been fascinated with the Chicago or the mafia, like. Like, this is the dressing side, like, Al Capone. And so when I was in Chicago, I went to go see that street that had, like, the Bloody Valentine.
Okay.
That got shot up on Valentine.
Yeah.
I not condone vice, but I guess I'm fascinated by just, you know, history, how they used to roll back in the day with the Chicago vibe and without opponent them. And so, but I'm totally against, you know, having shootouts and people, you know, losing their lives to senseless gun violence. But I will say I do like how they used to roll back in the day with, you know, just attire, if you will, just the, you know, picturesque of it.
Look, they ain't even just O-Block. You be sitting right there and your whole ponytail will be somewhere else, baby. They shoot. Knock the top off your head. But look, now I had to just, I think it was just a different move though, because I do have girls. So the environment.
Okay.
Here, the school is
How many
good.
Girls do you have?
I have two daughters and they are preteens. Oh, so I have almost 12.
Girl, I got a little 9-year-old nephew. Think he wants a hottie.
Yeah, I have like almost a 12 and 14 year old. So. I wanted to get my girls out of the city, and it's just, and you know, people might be like, "Oh, you sound so contradicting yourself," but I didn't want my kids.
No, you're not.
I didn't want my kids to grow up with my friend's son.
And you know what? That's just how they used to make me feel, because I grew up in the hood and was able to make it out and go to college, and they thought that, you know, I was too good for them. Oh,
yeah.
She went to college. She thinks she this, she that. Nah, I just know myself worth. I know I might have been born in the gutter, but that's not where I belong, and that's not where I'm going
to
end.
The goal is to get out.
And I will never forget where I come from.
Absolutely.
I don't know anybody who works that hard, go to college, or even if they don't go to college, but just and try to work out, I mean, work themselves out of that situation just to go back. And so don't feel ashamed or be mad about it, and don't give a F about what nobody says.
Okay.
You did what was right for you and best for you and yours. And so I commend you for that, Queen.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah.
And I commend you on just educating myself today and the viewers and listeners as well. Like you said, it is so much racism, controversial that is going on out here. And I do appreciate you taking the time to put a what if book out there to answer some of those questions, or even put some of those scenarios out there and took people's eyes who might didn't ever even think that those things was a vision or even can even hear about it. So I do definitely appreciate you. I'm going to check back in with you a little bit more when it comes down to like the fall season, just to see what type of events you have done or what you have coming up. And we will chat on a one-on-one with the pop-up shop. And just to give me a little bit more about Houston, because
this
is my new hometown, Difernt.
Welcome to H-Tag. You ain't going nowhere, girl.
Look, I brought some Chicago with me, too, so, okay.
Okay. Also, Queen, let me just take this time to thank you and remind you that you got a crown in your head and you were rocking it well. And I'm so appreciative and grateful for you to have me in your show. Thank you to everybody out there listening. And I just want to give a quick shout out to my nephew, my Pookie. That's his voice you guys heard on the book trailer. And so also everybody out there, remember, just manifest, plan, and prepare for what it is that you want in life, and it'll come to you. And no, don't worry about what nobody else has to say or think. Do you get yourself together, because once you get your heart together, you can get your mind right. You can do anything you want in life, anything.
Absolutely.
And, you know, that's Difference World. Come and learn.
Thank you. Until next time, it's been real. I'll talk to you soon.
Thank you so much.
Welcome back. I hope you guys enjoyed listening to my audio interview with Let's Be Real Podcast. I had a very good time talking with Shay about my new book, What If? A Controversial Paradigm Shift. Don't forget, it's actually on pre-sale right now on my website, differenceworld.net. Again, be advised that this is for grown folks only. So if you see it right there, okay, even though it's set up in rudimentary form, this is a grown folks book. So if you can't take this type of heat, do not bother coming to this kitchen. What else real quickly before I close out this video? The month is October, and so we will be doing a segment on breast cancer awareness as well as domestic violence abuse prevention month. So stay on the lookout for that. Other than that, let's see what else. Be sure to like, subscribe, and share this video and comment on it. As well as, don't forget, anybody out there listening, whatever it is that you want in life, don't forget to manifest, plan, and prepare for it, and it will surely come to you. Other than that, you guys check out the book trailer. Bye. Difference World. Come and learn.
What if?
What if in 1619 Africans started dealing in slave trading?
The tables were turned around.
What if they kidnapped millions of Englishmen, women, and children from their homeland and brought them to America on a slave ship?
What if a controversial paradigm shift is a book written to inform and encourage consistent, thought-provoking conversations about injustice and systematic racism in America through graphic but provocative illustrations? What if provides a different perspective by detailing controversial deaths and events as four categorized paradigm shifts: historical, political, precedent, and hypothetical? What if A Controversial Paradigm Shift by author Difernt. Illustrations by Anastasia Arnold. Coming August 2021. Go to differenceworld.net.